Good morning, Shell.
Good morning to you, Ferdinand.
Welcome here in the stand of Royal Rest in Holland.
Thank you very much.
Well, you're the architect of the Royal Rest pillow.
Yes, that's true.
And I'm quite interested, why did you develop this product, this pillow?
Well, it's quite a special story behind it, because I was on a trip to the Far East and my wife had contracted lumbago and she was bedridden. And when I came back home, she also had got neck pains. The pain has traveled up her neck. And at that time, about more than 15 years ago, I remember that there was one pillow in the market that helped for special neck problems. So I went to get that pillow. But however, she felt that was too hard.
Okay.
And my wife, being a technician,
she
said, why can't we make one ourselves? So I went actually to a shop where they cut pillows to your requirements.
Okay.
And I went there and I had a foam piece which she had drawn for me. And when she tried it, it was too soft. And she said, can't we make something that's in between, that's not too hard and not too soft? And we found very quickly that you just can't make it from one material, because then you have to compromise. Should it be supportive and maybe too hard? Should it be too soft, not giving support? So we found very quickly we have to combine different hardnesses.
Okay.
So this is how this came about. Mm-hmm. This pillow, our Royal Rest pillow, as we named it, Royal Rest, is made out of two different hardness of foam. Yes.
Okay.
It is polyurethane, and the cores here, which are for the support, are of a almost three times harder material than the body material, which is soft. Well, if I should ask you, what do you want from a pillow? Which are the two most important factors?
Well, I think that support should be very important for
it. Right, I agree.
And that it is soft enough to lay on it.
Comfortable.
Comfortable, yes.
Okay, so what you want is actually a comfortable support, to put it in one sentence.
Exactly.
Right, okay.
Yes, that would be nice.
Now, so we had these two requirements in our mind when we made the pillow.
Uh-huh.
How to make comfortable support. Okay,
yes.
We went out from the fact that we had to combine two different materials.
Yeah.
Actually, my wife is an engineer, and she is actually the mind behind
so
the special construction.
She is also the designer together with you.
Always the woman behind the man, as you say. Right. Now, we found very quickly that if we should have a round core in here, we would not reach a maximum comfort for the support, because we would get a counter pressure to the neck.
Because
if you exercise pressure onto a round object, you get the same pressure back. So we found, we discussed along the terms, how do we avoid the counter pressure? We came up with the idea of shaping the round core into a more oval type of core, and then putting it diagonally into the pillow like this. This means that when you exercise pressure from above, the core flexes inwards, so it bends, thus giving a minimum pressure and maximum support. And this is actually the whole idea behind it. And then we said, okay, why don't make we two heights in order to make a multiple choice for people, so that you don't have to, for instance, for the people who stock it, have too many pillows in stock. So this is actually the story behind it.
Okay. Another question. There are many pillows in the market.
Right.
Also very cheap pillows.
Well,
why should they not choose for a cheap pillow instead of this Royal Rest? It's more expensive. So what's the reason?
Well, it's a very good question, because there are many pillows in the market, and some are very cheap. You can go to, well, quite famous named supermarkets when you're buying some lamb chops or whatever you're doing, and you get a cheap pillow. And I usually say, those pillows, well, use them for washing your car instead.
Okay.
but still, what you want to fulfill the two requirements, comfort and support.
Yes.
So you should, of course, try many pillows.
But they're not comfortable, you say?
Well, after a while, I should say, or even already from the beginning, a lot of pillows are too hard.
Too hard.
Because when you have neck problems, you are very sensitive here.
Yeah, very sensitive.
And this is a fact, not the least for people with whiplash injuries. Only in my country, in Sweden, from where I come, we have a minimum registered events every year of around 20,000.
Okay.
And when you have a whiplash injury, which usually occur when you're hit from behind in driving a car, it's very difficult to diagnose, but you still need a good pillow when you're resting, because you have to have to position your body in the right alignment. And the slightest pressure to your neck is very painful. And we are actually officially recommended by the Swedish Whiplash Injured Association.
Okay.
Because of the fact that it is so soft and still giving the right support.
Yeah. So you say it is softer, it is giving better support than any other pillow in the market.
The combination of
combination.
I should say.
Yeah.
Well, some years ago we conducted a very extensive research in Germany. We interviewed 3,800 people, all of them of course also users of the Royal Rest pillow, but most of them had experience with one to five pillows before.
Okay.
And what we found in that, in another study I will come back to also, is that more than 85% of all individuals, they want to have a soft pillow, but at the same time giving the right support.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
There you have the tricky question, how to balance that. And that is what I think we have found, or I'm convinced of that we have found in our combination.
Okay.
Some years ago also, the only independent study of investigation, six different pillows as such, was made at the university in Lund.
Okay. Yeah.
There they compared from different criteria six different types of pillows from England, from Germany, from Switzerland, and from Sweden. And our pillow came out the absolute number one. And there were well-known pillows. You know, from Sweden, we have three famous pillows made.
Yes.
Royal Rest being the one, and I don't know if I should mention the two other ones. But they were also part of the study, and ours came out the absolute number one. And
that is,
the reason for that was actually that they were not names of the pillows, of course, when they were surveyed. But the reason, the main reason for choosing our pillow as the absolute number one, was that they perceived when lying down and using the pillow that it was giving the very comfortable support that we had as our aim when we were making the pillow.
Okay, super. Well,
actually the study, which was also published in a magazine called JMPT, the Bible of the chiropractor, so to speak, in the United States, pointed out as a
good promotion for you as well.
I should say we were the only ones who bought some extra copies of that magazine. But the interesting thing is that the conclusion of the study pointed out these facts I mentioned to you about the but also pinpointing that this was created by the soft material and these two specially designed cores.
Well, great. Thank you to hear this and to hear also the story behind the pillow. So I'm happy with it.
So am I, and I actually take this opportunity of wishing all your customers, patients and clients Royal Rest.
Thank you very much.
Okay thank you.
Thank you. Good morning, Shell.
Good morning to you, Ferdinand.
Welcome here in the stand of Royal Rest in Holland.
Thank you very much.
Well, you're the architect of the Royal Rest pillow.
Yes, that's
and
true.
And I'm quite interesting. Why did you develop this product, this pillow?
Well, it's quite a special story behind it, because I was on a trip to the Far East and my wife had contracted lumbago and she was bedridden. And when I came back home, she also had got neck pains. The pain has traveled up her neck. And at that time, about more than 15 years ago, I remember that there was one pillow in the market that helped for special neck problems. So I went to get that pillow. But however, she felt that was too hard.
Okay.
And my wife, being a technician, she said, why can't we make one ourselves?